So Svelte's different, is it's its own thing because it takes this idea that for so long we've been shipping a JavaScript library, right? So the framework or whatever we're using is a library, and that whole big chunk has to go along to every user that opens up your site. They go to your site to check out a recipe or something, they're getting that big bundle. What Svelte does differently is it takes your Svelte files and compiles it to just JavaScript. As in, we're not shipping a library full of code that you may or may not be using in every project. However, we're transforming the code that you are using into smaller bits of JavaScript that you can ship to the client and not have to worry about if this project is large enough or substantial enough to include such a giant bundle of JavaScript along with every single project.
It tries to do as much of the work the build time instead of in the runtime. What that means is that whereas, for example, React will do some work to compute the difference between what's currently on the page and what should be on the page, Svelte will take that logic and it will try and do as much of it as possible before the application even runs in the browser. And the way that we do that is we have a compiler. A compiler takes your declarative component code and it turns it into an approximation of what you would have written if you were writing this very hand-optimized vanilla JavaScript.
It's pretty similar to React. When you look at the compiled output of Svelte, it has a component, it has a lot of local state methods, it has a small little scheduler, but Svelte does not have a virtual DOM, and React does. Virtual DOM has been kind of sold as a way for React to be faster or more correct for a long time. And I think it took Svelte to offer a different alternative that really woke me up to the idea that I don't actually need this. I only think I need this because people told me I need this. And I think that there was a talk that actually Rich gave here in New York City, and he said, you people are kind of drinking the Kool-Aid, and you don't actually need all this machinery in order to do components right. And then he showed how he did it in Svelte. And the difference is night and day. Like the baseline React app is like 120 kilobytes. A basic Svelte app that says hello world will take like less than 3 kilobytes, like much less than that probably. I haven't even measured because it basically compiles down to what you would write by hand.
I think there's a lot of hype around Svelte, specifically because people don't believe it can be that easy, or they don't believe that the code they can write is so clear, because we have a long history of writing complex JavaScript code, specifically to do interactive elements on the web. And so what Svelte allows us to do is to write code that's not only small and simple, but plain and readable in a way that I think instantly attracts people when they try it.
I think people talk about it because it represents such a refreshing approach compared to the React paradigm, maybe the Angular paradigm, and even Vue. And I actually started in Vue before I turned to React, and then React to Svelte. It felt so much closer to the metal in terms of the language. And this is something I always say, the first language of the web is HTML, not JavaScript, not some weird syntax of JavaScript, it's HTML. And the reason that other libraries integrate so nicely with Svelte is because Svelte is a superset of HTML. And that's something I think is a strong design choice that just led to a lot of good decisions down the line.
If you use something like React or Vue, it's kind of stuck together using JavaScript. And if you're very familiar with JavaScript and thinking in a certain sort of way, then that sort of system is really great and really helpful. But if you're maybe a little bit newer, or it's not even in your best interest to learn the ins and outs of different JavaScript frameworks, if you use something like Svelte, you're mostly just looking at basic HTML JavaScript, but you have these superpowers now of, you know, you can have a for loop within HTML, or you can show something whether or not a certain variable is true. And I think it doesn't force you to learn a lot of framework-specific concepts. Instead, it'll introduce concepts that even if you're going on to a React job, you're going to need to learn in the first place. And I think it's just like a really nice stepping stone to a React job, or just you know, the way that you might build apps from now on.
JavaScript frameworks can come and go. We've seen a ton of them. But I really feel that this change to Svelte and its simplicity is not a fad. It's not a hype train. It's not anything that is going to just come and disappear. I think Svelte has attracted enough talented developers at this point where it's here for good, and it's only going to get better. Because as we've seen through Svelte's growth and progression already, it just continues to get better and better. I don't think Svelte's going anywhere. One of the best things about Svelte being as dynamic and as interesting as it is that when people try it, they stick with it and they give it high approval ratings and they feel very good about their time using it. So I think we're just gonna see more and more people try it, like it, and stay with it. Not to say that it's going to take over or become the next thing or something like that, but I strongly feel like it's not going anywhere. The code experience, the developer experience, everything is just too good.
It's incredibly gratifying when we see things like the State of JavaScript survey or the Stack Overflow survey saying that Svelte is the framework with the highest level of satisfaction, or it's the best loved framework. Like, obviously that strokes our egos a little bit, but we try not to let it go to our heads, because I think there is a phenomenon at work here, which is that the people currently using Svelte, because it is still a fairly niche framework, by and large they're doing so because they want to. So it's a self-selected group of people who are answering those surveys. When Svelte gets bigger, if it does continue to become bigger, then more of those developers will be people who found themselves working on a Svelte code base, but not through choice. And at that point, you know, those numbers, they're gonna drop off. And so our challenge is to try and keep people as enthusiastic about Svelte as they are now, while the framework continues to grow.
How do we want to do this? So if there's a chart of satisfaction and usage, it usually starts low, but there's a lot of satisfaction. And as it grows in usage, because people are so satisfied, usually there's like this curve where it, once everybody starts to use it, they feel obligated to use it, and then they all start using it, and then they're like, oh no, I was forced to use this, and so they're a little bit less satisfied, and then it like kind of dies out. And I feel like this is the cycle you usually see with JavaScript frameworks. What's different is like how far up they go, like how much usage do they get, how slow is the curve, that kind of thing. With Svelte, it's hard to tell, I think, if they're just following the same curve where usage is a little bit lower and so satisfaction is really high, but it really does feel a little bit different where there's quite a bit of usage these days and satisfaction is still, I think, the highest or one of the highest for any of the larger or more used JavaScript frameworks. So I think there's definitely some magic in where it sits, where like it's not a super heavy framework. You don't have to learn a lot of domain specific language. There's a lot of it that really just works for a large number of use cases.
Doesn't matter to me that Svelte is less popular than React. You know, obviously what I'm doing here is I'm trying to make Svelte more popular, but I don't want it to win some, like, the most popular framework in the world. Doesn't matter. It matters to me that I'm more productive in Svelte than I am in React, and I can attest to that for a fact.